just going into the general fund, getting money or anything like that?
The coastal money, we never see them, so.
No, no, I said, yeah, the deal, in the policy, when it was originally developed, it was very directly and deliberately determined that the comps are third-party billing from insurers would be held by the town, or the town control that account, and then would be used to offset what the cost of the EMS operations on the town. But has there been a problem? No, what, I think what, I don't want to speak for Leonard, but what I understand is that there is a desire on the part of Janus to provide compensation as a way of recognizing the service of the EMS volunteers, and if there's money remaining at the end of this year, that will be distributed to the membership. Is that fair?
Yes.
So, anyway, so that's, those are the highlights, I think, of the post-policy and the changes from the system.
Bob, any more questions?
No, really.
Leonard?
Actually, the two that I had were answered, so I'm not ready right now.
Done?
I'll put something together. The original policy is only 2 pages long, I'm not missing anything, right? And then it goes into the council litany?
Yes, it is just a page.
Okay. What I've been saying for quite a while is, within the policy itself, what I was looking to see incorporated in it were the standards of whatever they are. What you proposed tonight, I guess these additional words is what you're saying. I'm assuming you're saying now you want to put these in here?
Is that a question?
Your definitions that you handed out.
Well, the definition, in other words, what I think you're asking is, the questions you had were, as I spoke to Leonard regarding it, what the good standing definition would be, what the shift definition would be, things of that nature. And in fact, they have been there all along. The agreement, as you can see, is much more detailed than the original proposal. It's now, I guess, 3 pages of detail. What it's doing, it's referencing to, and it has reference to, for example, good standing, as the requirements it says under that caption, enumerated in the GEMS policy and procedure. So what we provided for you to help answer your questions and hopefully address them is a copy of the GEMS policy and procedure. And that's where it talks about the minimum training requirements. And it also talks about you know, what will constitute a member of good standing, which would be eligible for the incentives. And I think you also had a question further on about shifts, what the definition of a shift is.
Well, let's take the first one first.
Whatever you want to do.
Okay. When you talk about that standard, what I'm asking for to be in the policy, because that standard has changed, it's changed unbeknownst to the council. Over the years, the standard now is down to 75% of training opportunities. And council never knew that it had changed from attending one per month. So what I'm saying is that I would prefer to see the standard in the policy that the council sees, so they know what's going on.
Can you show me where that is going in this policy?
It's not. It's in the second thing he just handed out. And what I was asking for, and my concern is that whatever standards we have should be in our policy that we see.
It's in his policy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, they're separate documents. The incentive program is in this document. And then, and it refers to, as Guy said, refers to the policies and procedures, which I actually called Bruce today and asked the same question.
Yeah.
Is that, and you think that the incentive program proposal should include the definitions?
The way I look at the policy is, if it's going to be between GEMS and the council will know what they're agreeing to. Mm-hmm. If they have the ability through policy, which we never see, can change it, they're down next year to 50%. It's gone from one per month, now down to 75% of the 12. Next year it could be down to 50%, but you see, the council never knows that. So that's where I'm saying, whatever the agreement is, it should be in the policy.
I think we've come a long ways from the original SCANT agreement. I don't think your questions are inappropriate. However, I think we provided these to you, and it's a representation on this incentive plan of what it is.
Okay, well, that's just one point.
We're here today for the council's approval, and as of the date of the approval, it is what it is. That's the agreement. So your question was appropriate, but the 75%.
But you're wrong there when you say the agreement in place stays, because it doesn't. When this agreement was put in 5 years ago, the policy and procedures at that point are not the same that are there now. They've been changed.
I'm talking about here today. What we're showing is the proposed changes and the current policy and procedure, so we can disclose to you what it is, so you have it in front of you.
Right. So what I'm saying is, I feel that should be in here, so that everyone.
Well, I don't think there would be a problem attaching it as Exhibit A if that would be a comfort level.
I'd rather see it in the body.
Okay.
If you're going to have the definition of what?
Incorporated as an Exhibit A.
Can I ask a question here? Your new incentive plan talks about good standing. And it says and who volunteer services for a minimum of one shift per month for the incentive period. And your policies and procedures. Member of good standing is an active member.
Thank you for this group.
I know. Is that it? Wait for the horn.
One shift per month means that you do one slot per week. It could be Monday daytime or Tuesday nighttime. That is one shift.
The month is scheduled.
The month is scheduled.
That's not clear.
Okay.
That would be better if it was more clear.
So the definition of a shift is once a week for a month.
Well, the second one I brought up was to put the definition of what constitutes a shift in the body of this, because don't know what it is according to this. It could be a 12-hour shift during the week, it could be a 6-hour shift on the weekend.
The third page we handed out, there was
perhaps a shift. I'm saying, that's something that should be in here. Okay. But there's also an explanation that I'm told you have the latitude where someone can work, and Guy and I talked about this earlier, where 4 hours on Monday, 4 hours on Wednesday, and 4 hours on Friday constitutes 12 hours for the week. And I don't think that was the intent, ever.
That's not true. That happens never. That's not in any
case. So they do 6 hours on Monday, 6 on Thursday?
Yeah, I think the question you had was about four, but I, just to respond, to be clear, I answered that I had thought that there was one EMT who did 6 hours on two different dates, but I'll let that answer.
Yes, we do have that case. We have two ladies that share Monday. One do mornings and the other one do afternoons. And do the same thing on Tuesdays.
But you should put that in here without the intent that you're, to what level you're going to allow that is what I'm saying. If you're going to define your shift.
Okay.
I think what he's saying is saying a shift is defined as 12 hours per week of duty. Mm-hmm. That would cover that. You could be 4 hours on 3 days.
No. They're not allowed to.
Well, I'm just saying, though.
Six.
Equals 12.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that you should do that.
That's the question, Mrs. Whatever you're going to allow to get credit for, you should put in the policy so that we know what it is.
I think the consistency between the incentive plan and what the policies are throughout the definitions and everything else would be.